Do you want a brand new home that blends contemporary and retro vibes? Well, then you're gonna wanna check out this brand new Perry home for sale in New Braunfels for $497,000. And if you're already ready to begin your purchase, stop watching this video, get in contact with the information in the bio. Well, let's go check it out. What's up guys, Alec Hernandez, realtor with the Miramont Group, and today we're out in the beautiful New Braunfels, Texas, satellite city of San Antonio, and we're going to be checking out this contemporary and retro brand new Perry home that's for sale in the Veramendi community. I'm so excited for you to check it out, and without further ado, let's get right into it. So right off the bat, you're going to notice this is kind of like that, I don't know if you guys played Black Ops, the original one, not the new one, back in the day, Nuketown. You know, this kind of gives me a retro vibe just from the exterior, and I totally dig that, because Perry didn't used to have a home, or didn't used to build floor plans that kind of had that more retro vibe to them. However, they started blending that in the recent years, and so that's already the first thing that sticks out about this property to me. Again, you get some nice windows from the exterior, blending stone and siding and stucco all together, and then you have that white and black contrasting on each other, because you can't go wrong with the black and white colorway. So walking up, what you're gonna notice, you get some tile right here in the very front beginning of your porch. It's not just concrete. Like you'll notice on other homes, it's just a concrete bare slab that you see right here, but they went ahead and added tile. You get the stone as you're walking up to give it that just the stoop feeling to it, right? Got black trim on the windows, not just like a regular gray or brown. It's the black, which I think always makes it look a little bit better. And it is covered, so if it's raining and you're trying to get inside the house and you're fumbling your keys, you don't gotta worry about getting wet, right? So front door, glass paneling, that's a Perry thing. When you get into this type of property series, you're shopping in these price points, that's just something that you can expect from a builder. And if you're not getting it, let me know, because we'll find you something better, okay? So once you make your way in, of course it's a Perry home, so we gotta look up. You get the cutout in the ceiling, it's not just a flat one, and they are elevated. That's at least probably 12 feet or so, something like that, right? And then right off to the right, what you're gonna notice is you get a first bedroom. This is a three bedroom, three bath property plus an office, okay? So right here in the beginning, you get that first bedroom. And I don't know about you guys, but if I was a kid, this would totally be the one that I want, because look at these unique, slender and tall windows that you get, these bay ones, to allow a whole bunch of natural light to seep in. You get the view of the front. You even have this nice accent window up top. That's a, don't even know what to call that. Is that a trapezoid? I'm forgetting I don't even know the name of geometry. My geometry is off right now, okay? I'm sorry, guys. But then if you look up too, you'll notice that it's not just a flat ceiling. Like from the outside, you can tell that this is totally that front bedroom, because the way that it slants, kind of like a ramp if you're skateboarding or something. And then right here, you get the closet space, right? Not walk-in, but it is wide enough to fit a bunch of things, so you don't have to worry about that. You get the nice design and the door cut out too, of course. And you do actually have another window right here, so you got door knockers or something, you can just take a peek right there and decide whether or not you want to open the door or not. Unless it's me, then you always answer the door for me, okay? And then you get the wood look-alike tile right here in the main areas and in the bathroom area. This bedroom right here has a bathroom pretty much right offset to it, so it's pretty much your own. Or if you're hosting, this is probably the one that you send people to, because it's not located within a bedroom, right? And then you get the solid countertops, you get the nice cabinetry, and then you get a full shower right here with the tile work. It's not just acrylic, and then a little bit different tile down there just to kind of spruce it up a little bit, okay? Now we'll make our way more forward to the home. They did stage this one, so it gives you an idea of what it could look like. Again, wide hallway, so you could fit something like this off to the side and you don't gotta worry about bumping into it. Sometimes they're a little bit more narrow, you know what I mean? But making your way forward, you're gonna enter into the, I called it a study or game room. A study or an office, but really it looks more or less kind of like a game room or like a TV room, how they have it set up. But it does have the French doors. There's no window and there is no closet in here, so you can't call it a bedroom. When you see things like this, this tells me that they're imagining that you have like a TV setup or maybe like a projector screen setup, because you got some of these cable things in there. I don't even know who uses cable anymore, so they should probably invest their resources elsewhere. Perry, I hope you're watching these videos. Get some nice architecture in the ceiling, some nice lights. Yeah, this is set up for a home theater because these little plugins right here, if you're probably wondering what they are, that's where you put the surround sound speakers. Because when you do a home theater, it's not just like one speaker setup. Like you have a couple of them so that way the sound can come from where it's supposed to, like diagonal or what's the, like, I know it's called surround sound, but they call it like 3D audio or 8D audio, something like that, right? And then you're coming over here. This is the entrance to your garage right through here. It is a full, it's a three car garage actually, because it kind of snakes around right there and goes deeper. So you can kind of see it, they call that a tandem. It's a three car garage, but it only looks like a two car from the front. Okay, and then you have the little mud room area. So if you park your car in the garage, you got muddy boots or any boots or whatever, you just kind of set them right here. Backpacks maybe when you're getting the kids ready to go for school or when they come back home type of thing. So making our way even further through the home, it opens up into the grand kitchen, dining, and living area, all flows together, right? So you have a nice big island right here in the middle of your kitchen. Probably wouldn't do any bar stools right here. Doesn't make any sense, but you could use this as a spread for the food and whatnot for all my foodies out there who like to cook. It is gas in this community, so you get a little gas cooktop right here and tons of counter space really on this one. Right, you do get the built-in, so they're not just like hanging out by themselves because there is no stove down there like you might normally see. So built into the home, which gives it a little bit more elevated profile, right? Again, Perry with the nice big cabinets. These are soft close, so you try to... Well, I slammed it pretty hard, but they close pretty gently, okay? Don't get too strong on it. Again, deep sink, right? It's not just a shallow one. Stainless steel appliances. And then right here, this is a nice little touch that they added. You have a little bit more counter space, but some built-in shelving right here to maybe add some decor, kind of how they have it. Maybe put some family photos and whatnot, because at one point in time, or in the near future, this will be a home and not just a house. The way I'm showing it to you right now is just a house, okay? Right here, you have kind of a walk-in pantry. So for all those midnight snack cravings, stick them all in there and you'll have a place to come find them. Oh, another thing I'll point out on the island right here, it's got some shelving built into it, or some cabinets, so you can do some storage there too. I'm sure you might have seen when you were looking that way, that's the cutout for the fridge. Big open concept right here. You get some windows to allow some natural light in right here by the dining area. It looks like they have a 6-person table here. You might be able to get away with a little bit bigger, although it might eat up a little bit of the space right here. You don't want to mess up the feng shui in the home, okay? You don't want to be running into things. But then it also opens up right into your living area, all one concept. Again, more windows right there on the back to allow that natural light to seep into it. And you can get an idea of how you might set up your home if this one was yours. And then looking at it right now, I don't want to miss it, but nice little backsplash that they added in. Backsplashes always add a nice little touch to kitchens, make it look more luxurious. So they went ahead and did that one for you on this one. You get a little hall closet right here, throw your coats in there and whatnot. We're making our way through this little hallway right here. You're gonna get another full bath. This one's not a shower, it has the tub, but it still has the tile work around it again. So it's not just the acrylic. You're gonna get the hard top countertops right here. Okay, same wood look-alike tile going on through there. And then right here, you get your utility room, which is big enough for a full-size washer and dryer. So they go side by side, okay? You don't have to have them stacked up, some built-ins there. And then a little bit more area right here for maybe like an ironing board or however you set up your utility room. Kind of like the sizing on this one. Wish mine was about that big. Mine's a little bit smaller. So right here you have one of the other secondary bedrooms, the second bedroom. You get one window coming in. So you will get some light, but not nearly as much as that front bedroom. So kids, older siblings, younger siblings. I was the younger one. I always got the less cool room, so this probably would have been mine. However, you can rock, paper, scissors, duke it out, whatever you're gonna do to decide who gets what bedroom. Again, pretty much the same type of closet, not quite a walk-in, but it is wide. So you will have some space on, you know, both sides behind this drywall that you can't really see to be able to put some storage there, okay? Right here, this door, it's just another closet. So some more storage, or if you want to put your coats there, it's really up to you. And then, as we make our way back here, Nice little window right here. It's not necessary, although it definitely adds just some more character, some more flavor to the home. I think the more opportunities you have to put windows, allow some natural light to seep in without making it feel like you're just adding windows in, that's an art in itself, right? So they have one right here. I think it's cool. It matches the vibe of the home. Right here is the entrance into your backyard. You do get a covered back patio, okay? And they have a gas line right here already built in. So if you wanted to add an outdoor kitchen, set it up probably like this, right? Where you see the limestone rock and whatnot with the grills cut out. It's a covered patio, so you can chill out here when it's raining. Don't gotta worry too much about the elements. And then you do get a decent sized yard. It's not the biggest one ever, although it does the trick. So if you have a small dog, this might work for it. Have enough space for him to run around and do their business and whatnot. Just make sure you pick it up after they're done. You don't want your yard getting all messed up, right? But yeah, kind of stucco in the exterior. It's not siding, so it's a solid home. Remember, Perry stick builds their home, one by one stick. It's not a prefabricated wall, so they're sturdy, sturdy structures, okay? And then right through here, where the king and queen lay their head to rest at night, this is the primary suite. They already have a fan installed for you. You can switch that up to give it a little bit more modern vibe, because usually when it comes to fans and fixtures like that, when you buy a home, they're not gonna give you the best ones. You can go on Amazon or Home Depot or Lowe's, probably find something that's pretty affordable that looks a little bit nicer, right? Then again, just some big windows to allow that natural light to seep into your bedroom. Again, just the black cutout just adds a nice, elegant taste to the property. And when you're entering into your primary spa, your spa day, you get the little French double doors. It's not just a one door entry. So that's pretty cool. In here, you actually get some different flooring. This is actual tile and it's not made to look like anything other than nice tile, okay? But come on in. You get this standalone tub. It's got the tile work around it. It's not just acrylic popping out, and it's a big tub. So I would fit in there. If you're a little bit bigger than me, you should fit in there. You get the dual vanity sinks, his and hers. So you have one right here, and then you have another lip right here to maybe put a seat for maybe the lady to put her makeup and whatnot. She wants to get dolled up and get pretty. And you have one right behind you right here. And then you also get the shower in case you just feel like showering. You don't want to be in the tub. It's got the tile work around it. No acrylic, a little bit different tile on the bottom. Again, just like in that first bathroom I showed you guys. And then you get his and her closets. So you get one of the walk-ins right here. And it's already got this built-in right here for your shoes, for that sneaker collection. Put them all right there. Designer goodies, you got some space for it. And then right over here, you also get your facility. It's in its own room, so you don't gotta mix up the fumes. You don't gotta worry about that, right? And then you get the his or hers, whichever one who's gonna be for who. If you got superstition, you can figure out which one is gonna work better for your feng shui and your flow. Again, the built-ins, spacing, it's walk-in. So for all your designer goodies, that bag collection, you're gonna have plenty of ample space for it. Guys, if you made it this far along, I appreciate you so much. That means you definitely like me and you like watching these tours. So make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And that's pretty much gonna wrap up this tour. I appreciate you being here. I know you could have been anywhere. Make sure you guys are tuning in for more of these tours. We've been seeing the channel grow. We're so close to 100 subscribers, so we'll do a little mini giveaway. I thank you, and we will see you on the next ones. My information has been all throughout this video. Reach out to start your home buying journey. Peace. I missed the piece. Okay, let me do the piece.
You said it. You wanted to start over from here?
I'll just add the piece, and then I'll just clip it in. Oh, you already going?
Yeah.
No. Peace.